7 years, the trust performed merely a supporting role, for such was the power and influence of Rabbi Sacks's thoughts, writings, and teachings that, frankly, the trustees had little to do. That all changed with his all too early death last year. And so the trust reinvented itself, renamed itself the Rabbi Sacks Legacy Trust, and most importantly, brought family members on board and has set about its task to ensure that future generations continue to engage and learn from Rabbi Sacks's teachings and ideas, which so successfully spanned the religious and secular worlds. Tonight's conversation is the first public step in fulfilling the trust's responsibility.
We're here to express really the depths of our feelings for Jonathan Sacks, our friend, mentor, teacher, and a constant source of inspiration.
Tonight also sees the launch of The Power of Ideas, Words of Faith and Wisdom, a fantastic collection of Rabbi Sacks's broadcasts, articles, and speeches. His Royal Highness the Prince of Wales, in the foreword that he's written for the book, says, "This volume demonstrates once again Rabbi Sacks's unique capacity for interpreting the present and predicting the future through a profound understanding of the past." The Sacks Conversation. A great idea for a series commemorating Jonathan. It so completely typifies the man whose life we celebrate and who made such an impact on our lives. Conversation was Jonathan's speciality. Open-minded, eager to exchange views, bringing those in discord into dialogue, seeking answers, but always with a deep inner humility and willingness to acknowledge the other and their point of view. The truth about Jonathan is that there was never any failure of imagination with him, not historical, prophetic, or spiritual. And that's the reason, that extraordinary power of imagination is the reason why I didn't merely like him as a person, I admired him deeply as a teacher. And that teaching, I believe, will live on long, long after the physical body has perished.
It's been a very emotional year, not helped by all the COVID limitations, and I want to thank you all, here in the hall and those of you watching at home online, for your warm friendship and great support. Thank you all.
It is a duty of all of us to ensure that his legacy lives on, for the good of us all and for the good of our community and the good of society in general. May his memory be a blessing to us all.